What is the determinant of a matrix? What does it mean? Okay, you've seen it appearing in all kinds of computations, so it is certainly a useful concept. But does it also mean something by itself? Yes, it does. It has a nice geometrical interpretation, as you will learn in this video. We'll look at 2x2 matrices here. So we will start with an easy example, a rectangle, with sides up till A and up till D. So we can form it using our vectors A1 and A2, where A1 is A0 and A2 is 0D. Of course, the area of a rectangle is just A times D. Now what happens if you put A1 and A2 in the matrix? Okay, then we form matrix A, we can do that. Here we have our matrix. And then we compute our determinant. Now what's the determinant? It's A times D, which is exactly equal to the determinant of A. So in this case, if you have such a really easy case, the determinant of your matrix, put absolute value, gives you exactly the area of your rectangle. Okay, I think this is a bit silly because we had a very easy case. What happens if we do it a bit more general? So if you have some parallelogram, take two vectors A1 and A2, you can form a parallelogram. You can always put it like this, such that A1 is aligned along the x-axis. Then we can, of course, compute the area of our parallelogram. It's equal to the determinant of A1 times H, where H is the height of your parallelogram. You can see this, for example, if you cut this part away and glue it here, then you have a rectangle again. So in this case, the area of your parallelogram equals the determinant of matrix containing A1 and H, similar to what's happening over here. Yeah, okay, but it contains A1 and H. It's not the determinant of a matrix A with A1 and A2. Well, actually, you can do a small trick. We say, okay, we can put a vector C times A1 over here. And now you see our vector A2 equals C times A1 plus H. So there we go. C times E1 plus H equals vector A2. I don't know what C is exactly, doesn't matter, as long as you have such a relation. Now we can solve for H. H equals vector A2 minus C times A1. Okay, what do we get then? The area of your parallelogram becomes the determinant of the matrix containing A1 and H. Well, taking transposes doesn't change your determinant, so if you take a transpose, then we get a determinant with A1 as row and H as a second row. Now we can substitute what we know about H. H was A2 minus C times E1. And now we can do the trick. We can do a row reduction step. We can add C times the first row to the second row. And that's really nice because then this part minus C times A1 is going to cancel out. So then we are left with a matrix which contains A1 as first row and A2 as second row. So the area of your parallelogram equals the determinant of A transpose. Well, but the determinant of A transpose is the same as the determinant of A. So the determinant of A should put absolute values if it's negative, of course. The determinant of your matrix A gives you the area of your parallelogram. So that is what the determinant of a 2x2 matrix means. If you have two vectors A1 and A2, you can form parallelogram, and the determinant of this matrix in absolute value will give you the area of your parallelogram.